I don't know if you can hear that. But that's the wind. Because we have a lot of trees in New England. and they fall and it's really scary. Good morning, YouTube. Welcome to the Tree That Courtney Lily. I'm your host, Lily, and that's my dog playing on the floor. And so it's been a month. Usually seems, because I posted like 3 videos in a row, like all within like 2 or 3 days of each other, and then I'm like, yeah, okay, I'm done. I don't need to do anything else for 2021. But so Ryan and I have COVID. It's not fun. Ryan texted me on Monday a couple weeks ago, or a week ago at this point. I was like, hey, I just tested positive for COVID. You need to leave work now. And I was like, yeah, I'm leaving work now. And it was like noon. I left work. And the following day on Tuesday, I started not feeling very good. And work's been great about the whole thing. So yeah, Tuesday I started exhibiting symptoms. And on Saturday, because I called and I was like, okay, we want you to wait 5 days before getting tested. If the symptoms start getting worse, if it's something to really worry about, then come in sooner for a test. But you know, like I knew I had it. Like Ryan has it. We sleep in the same bed. We live in the same house. I had it. So Saturday confirmed that I did contract COVID. My symptoms are fairly mild. I didn't have a fever, no trouble breathing. It's mostly been a cough and the stuffy nose, and I can't smell or taste anything. So that really sucks, because we have like chocolate chip espresso ice cream downstairs, and I ate it last night and it was like eating ice, really soft ice. We have like the greatest orange juice in the world downstairs. Can't taste it. I can literally not taste anything. So that's really shitty. I can feel texture of food, but I can't taste anything. But no trouble breathing, no fever. I did have really weird skin ache. That sounds really weird, and it was weird to experience, because basically it felt like my entire body was covered in the worst sunburn I had ever had. That's what it felt like. So yeah, this is where we are. this is where I'm at. This is week 2. I want to go back to work. I'm sick of being sick. I don't want to be sick anymore. However, we're both incredibly fortunate to have had a very mild case of COVID. We're both fairly healthy people. Ryan had different symptoms than I did. He had a fever for like 2 days. He had the worst body aches. Trying to watch him move around was really painful to watch, as equally as it was for him to be in that amount of pain. It was really rough on him, because Ryan's someone who works from home a lot, and he like works on cars and stuff like that, and he hasn't been able to do that because his body just can't. Ryan would get really winded, so would I. That's actually something else that we both got, was that I would take the dog out and come back in and be like, I need to crash. The first 3 days of being sick, I just slept a lot. I was so freaking tired. I'm still pretty tired, but we were able to take the dog out together and like get some fresh air. We've been having the windows open to get some ventilation in. No loss of appetite or anything like that. But yeah, we've just been at home and not, you know, not trying to overexert ourselves too much. Yeah, that is my journey with COVID so far, is that it sucks. And I'm really mad that I got it after literally almost a year to it all like happening. Almost exactly 1 year from when all of this started. I was working with the public when I still worked at Panera, and I didn't get sick. And I was just like, I was so careful, but you know, both of my sisters have already gotten, that's the thing. The only people in my family who have gotten it are myself and my sisters. I mean, my sisters kind of live in epicenters of it in a way, but they both live in cities, but I'm living out in the sticks. I'm literally living out in the sticks where there's like hardly anybody. I mean, there's neighbors, but like all of the neighbors are really around here are really, really good about staying away from each other. That wind is crazy. I hate wind. Driving in snow, I'm good. I can do that. Like, I don't like it, but I'll do it, you know, obviously if I have to. But wind, I don't like feeling the car move. It really freaks me out. But yeah, other than that, we're okay. And I've literally been sitting on my ass watching Farscape and Downton Abbey. And we finished the 5 seasons that are available of The Expanse in the time that we've been sick. Well, actually, we'd already been watching it. We were probably on season 2 and then watched 3, 4, and 5. Makes me really want to read the books again and order the books that I don't already have. And I'm really sad that the actor who played Alex turned out to be such a piece of shit, because Alex has always been one of my favorite characters from the Expanse books and then into the series. So that really sucked. I get why they killed him off. I totally understand, but I was so angry at that actor. I was so mad at him. Been watching a lot of Pixar. There's a down tree branch, like a big one, like a limb, not even a branch, it's a limb. And he was gonna go try and like move it. Should really go check on him.
Yeah, this isn't even the worst that some people get. But it's definitely not great. Yeah, like, that's not the worst, but like, see, it's not because of the mask, it's because I ran up the stairs, and it doesn't help that I'm still vaping, which I know I shouldn't be. I know, trust me, I know. Give me a second. But yeah, wind in New England is terrifying because there's fucking trees everywhere. So, even there's trees other places too. We're not the only place that has trees. I've been watching a lot of Pixar, all of my favorites pretty much. I watched all of the Toy Story movies because I'd never seen the 4th Toy Story movie. Honestly, it was okay. I feel like there was too many characters. That's kind of the reason why I love the first and the second one so much, is that it's still really small, even though you meet like the other Buzz and you meet the Barbies at one point. They're not in the whole movie. The Barbies aren't in the whole thing. They're in that one scene. I'm Tour Guide Barbie. Please keep your arms and accessories inside the vehicle at all times. I do a really good Barbie accent. Or not accent. I do a good Barbie voice, even though I look nothing like Barbie. But yeah, the 4th one is just like, she still ripped out your voice box. That wasn't cool. I don't know. It was just okay. I liked the 3rd one. I think they should have left it at the 3rd one. I didn't need more after the 3rd one personally, but I'm one of those people who is just kind of like, yeah, it's fine. It's okay. And it just didn't have the same kind of punchy humor that the 1st one had, or the 2nd one, in my opinion. The last two, the humor really shifts and changes a little bit. Like, they're still cute. Like, they're still cute movies. I still love the 3rd one, and I think the 4th one's cute, but it's just okay. Headcanon, and IMDb totally confirmed this, because I was like, because Andy's mom in the 2nd movie says Woody's an old family doll. And at first, my original theory was like, oh, I bet Andy's mom had Woody as a toy when she was a little kid. But it's kind of a boy's toy. And not that, you know, girls can't enjoy boy toys or anything like that. That just sounds weird when I say it. But on IMDb, they were like, it was because Andy doesn't have a dad. Andy's dad is nowhere in the picture. They don't talk about him, and he really idolizes Woody. So on IMDb, the theory is that Woody was actually Andy's dad's doll. He even recognizes what a record player is. And he's like, I haven't seen one of these in ages. There's no record player in Andy's house. So I thought that was cool. I felt validated in my fan theories. We can talk Star Trek for a second. I'll put some... I don't give a shit about Prodigy. I'm gonna fucking say it. I don't give a shit, okay? I don't know, but I also don't know why. With that being said, I don't know why other people are taking it so seriously that they're acting like they have a fucking gun to their head, as if someone at CBS and Paramount are like, you have to fucking watch this or I'm gonna shoot your whole family. It's like, why are you behaving this way? Because honestly, Ryan has a kid, okay? And if I wanted to watch a cute show that has to do with Star Trek with them, then I'm gonna fucking do it. I don't care. No one's taking your old Star Trek from you. No one's taking it. It's still there. It's still available for you to watch. It's accessible, it's beloved, it's iconic, and no one's taking that away from you. So I don't know why people are acting like they're coming for our Star Trek. It's like, it's still there. It's still there for you. But yeah, this has just been a little update video. I'm gonna lay down now. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. And stay tuned to the channel for more.